right, let's get to it. The recommendations keep coming in. This comes from Leto. He or she says, if you don't know this woman yet, listen to Tori Amos. The song is called Winter, and I guess winter is coming. It's from a performance live at Montreux from 91-92. She says, or he says, listen to the studio version, but both are good. So listen to the live version or the studio version. Both are good. This person does prefer the studio version. The live version is more raw, emotional. So I'm not sure. Maybe which one should I listen to? Well, which link did he give me? Let's do this one. I do know who Tori Amos is, by the way. I don't know any of her stuff. Like I couldn't sing you any of her stuff. And I certainly don't know this song, but I do know who Tori Amos is. I can't believe she's been around that long. There's a live performance from 91, 92. In my brain, she's like, I don't know, early 2000s artist. So she's a woman who sings and plays the piano, melodic, melancholic, yet fuzzy feelings afterwards, okay? Many people who are into metal also like her music. Don't ask me why, he says, but it's quite common. Well, we'll find out. I like metal. Let's see if I like Tori.
This is my last song. This is from my dad.
Change my day.
That's really nice. I had no idea. I mean, I had no idea that she sang like that. I've heard the name Tori Amos. This was from her first, well, her first debut album. She had a synth pop album that came out in 1988. It's kind of funny to look it up. It's called Why Can't Tori Read? It's an album by 1980s American synth pop band of the same name, fronted by then unknown singer and songwriter Tori Amos, but that kind of failed. So she did her first solo album called Little Earthquakes. And that's where this song comes from. That came out in 92. So it was recorded in 1991, but the album came out in 92. So this performance was fairly new for that song. The song is called Winter. It was the fourth single from the album. It had a very, like, Gaelic, I don't know if that's the right word, you know, Gaelic, Welsh, I don't know, that kind of feeling. She's an American singer, but definitely with her red hair, maybe she's got some background from that, you know, part of Europe. I loved it. It's beautiful. It's a timeless song. You know, I'm listening to this song in 2019 and there's no aging to that song. That's what I love about a good song. It doesn't have a decade attached to it. If you were to tell me that song came out last year, I'd be like, okay, sure. She sings it beautifully. She's a, you can almost like, for my Nightwish listeners, you could see her fronting Nightwish. You know what I mean? Like, there's a very, her voice is powerful, strong, and it's got that kind of European, I don't know how to word it, but you could see her being a part of, like, a lot of the Euro metal bands, you know what I mean? Great suggestion. I'm legitimately impressed by that, and I'm just never took her seriously throughout my years. I mean, granted, this came out in 92, and I was really, you know, I was 17 years old. There's no way I was going to listen to Tori Amos when I'm 17 years old, right? I was into, like, you know, heavy metal and, you know, Metallica and Guns N' Roses. You know, I wasn't going to listen to Tori Amos, so I do know the name. I mean, she was a big artist. She's 56 now, so pretty crazy. She was 28 during that performance. Cool. Great suggestion. This is the stuff I'm talking about. I love getting recommendations for bands, for artists, and what people think is their, you know, kind of like their best stuff to sell me on. That worked. That legitimately made me like Tori more than I would have 10 minutes ago. So, great suggestion. Tori Amos. Great sounding voice. Boy, that was live. Her live. That was beautiful.